People who are stateless have trouble accessing education, employment, healthcare benefits. They're also at very high risk of trafficking. And the relationship between racial equality is that the leading cause of statelessness is actually discrimination. Discrimination on the basis of race, ethnicity, religion. And so what you have is that the groups that are most worst off on account of statelessness are actually determined on the basis of their race and their ethnicity and their national origins. The effects of ethno-nationalism are toxic and they are widespread. And we're living at a time when ethno-nationalist ideologies are being mainstreamed. And so you'll see in the media, you'll see in public discourse, it's become very comfortable and acceptable to say that a particular nation is only for a particular racial group or for a particular religion. And that kind of discourse is completely unacceptable from a human rights perspective. The effects are extreme. You know, you have people who are being killed. You can think about the Rohingya people who are displaced and experience torture and killings all on account of ethno-nationalists. But those who are at risk are not limited to Jews. You have Muslims, minorities of all other kinds, sexual minorities. You have persons with disabilities who all end up being vulnerable to resurgent neo-Nazi ideology. And states need to take a much firmer stance against racial discrimination, ethnic discrimination, religious discrimination in the case of non-citizens who are in their countries, who are approaching their countries, speak out against hate, dismantle the structures that are doing the work of discrimination in the context of national security and especially economic anxieties as well. States must be very careful to ensure that they're upholding their commitments to racial equality.